Dear crystal lovers, today's vlogcast is based on a blog post that I did way back in March of 2020, but I think it's still very relevant, perhaps even more now than ever. I've come across people who have reported that their crystals have changed both physically and energetically, and I find that really interesting. As always, I'm giving you my own personal view on why I believe this phenomenon is occurring now and how it relates to planet Earth and this human life experience that we're all having here. In college, I majored in trends, specifically long-term global trends such as the impact of information technology and climate change, and I absolutely loved it. I've always had a keen interest in what it is that moves people globally to feel, think, and act differently than previous generations. And I do believe that as a species, we are in the middle of a fast shift that will change humanity forever, not only intellectually, but also energetically. Yes, the world is changing around us in obvious ways, but there's also something else happening from within. So what is different? Life is changing on planet Earth, not just because of the man-made events happening here like pandemics, cultural shifts, disclosure of political crime, changes in the global economy, and more knowledge being available for more people through the internet. Life on Earth is also changing on a cosmic level with more galactic cosmic radiation and radiation from the sun. It's impacting us, the Earth, and our crystals in a new way. At the same time, Earth's magnetic field is changing due to the shifting poles, so we do have a lot going on here right now. Crystal collectors and energy workers experience that their crystals are not working in the way that they're used to or the way that they expect them to, and that they're physically changing, for example, with record keepers, marks, inclusions, just showing up randomly. This is not a new phenomenon, but I think it's relevant to shine a light upon it now. I too have had these experiences. So the big question is, what is happening? In my view, there might be two explanations for this. One, that the crystals are changing on a molecular level due to actual physical influence, for example, from the change in gravity and radiation on Earth. The second one is that we as human beings are shifting and developing a more fine-tuned receptive mode, and therefore are better able to interpret the energy from crystals. Regarding the first one, I have to be honest and say that I am not a scientist and I do not have the tools to scientifically measure whether crystals are physically changing. So I will leave that theory for now. I do, however, have a bit of experience with people going through sensory shifts and unfolding new ways of interpreting energy. Personally, I have experienced major shifts in consciousness and perception in my own life, and I see it too in others around me. As a QHHT practitioner, I've had the pleasure of counseling many people who have experienced these shifts in their own awareness, where thoughts, actions, and behaviors that would have previously been tolerated now are completely unacceptable to them. They're seeing things more clearly than before, recognizing the source within themselves, and actively focusing their lives in a spiritual direction. Perhaps you yourself have experienced times when everything was turned around and upside down and awakened you to a whole new understanding of this experience of being in a human body on planet Earth. And perhaps that time is now. Maybe you found yourself having conversations with people whom you never thought would be open to metaphysics suddenly showing an interest. I know I get so surprised every time that happens in my life, but I absolutely love it. Life on Earth is extreme, and waking up to kindness, compassion, gentleness, balance, and harmony also emphasizes the lack thereof. It highlights the way in which the conditioned mind is affecting us and how difficult it really is to be accountable for our own emotions, thoughts, and actions. Awakening shines a light not only on the dark side of others, but also on yourself. And let me tell you, what you find might be a hot mess. Connecting spirit with this human experience seems for many to be a challenging task. How do you connect spirit and body in your daily life, in how you take care of yourself, in your work, in your relationships, and in the way you impact others and the planet? How do you actually have a balanced life that incorporates both your spirit self and your earthly self? And is it even possible? I think that's the biggest challenge for us right now. Bringing spirit into our everyday aspects of the human experience, and not one or the other, but both. This evolution of sorts is a lifelong and sometimes lonely inner journey of getting yourself back and connected to who you are. But that is really all that it is. You finding yourself over and over again. There are a number of tools you can use, one of them being crystals, of course, but also hypnosis, meditation, yoga, astrology, plant medicine, energy healing, literature, and even science. However, this is your journey, and remember that you don't need anything. The tools are not the answer, they are just assisting you. You may also find that different assisting tools will work for you at a certain time, and other times they might not. I know for sure that I'm not at the same energetic frequency that I used to be a couple of years ago, and definitely not 8 or 9, 10 years ago. For me, things are changing fast, and it's exciting, but I do like to have something stable to hold on to, and crystals definitely do that for me. They help me to focus and fine-tune my intentions and set everything into perspective. Early in life, I did not experience crystals energetically the way that I do now. So something has definitely changed for me within the last couple of years. Yes, they were pretty and all, but I didn't feel that they really did anything for me. Now they are my physical and energetic reminders of my intentions and some of my everyday spiritual anchors. I personally love crystals as an ally to incorporate spirituality into my everyday life. Honestly, because it is so easy. I love that there are natural, tangible objects that I can look at or wear, hold in my hands, put on my body, and have in my living space. What I also love about crystals is that they are physically connected not only to Earth, but also the entire universe, and time, and geometry, and science. I am curious to hear, what are your experiences? Have you experienced major changes in your life or your perception or in the way your crystals work? Do you believe that the energy is getting stronger or that we are simply more capable of receiving information or both? Let me know in the comments. And thank you so much for listening. And if you enjoyed this vlogcast and you like more of this type of crystal information, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. It helps to get the message out to those who are looking for it, and it helps me to know what you want me to talk about. Have a great day with lots and lots of love to you and to yours.